So in the last two videos, we learned how to use the Drupal component module to use your packaged JavaScript application as Drupal blocks and then place them on Drupal pages just like any other block. Not only that, we also learned in part two how to create web components or custom elements. This time in part three, we are going to add Svelte to the mix, and we are going to see how to create JavaScript applications with Svelte, and more importantly, creating web components and custom elements with Svelte and embedding them into your Drupal site. So let's get started. So in the previous videos, I hope if you do not know how to use the Drupal component module, please take a look at the previous two videos, and there I have explained it. And if you don't know much about Svelte, then you are at the right place, because I have a ton of Svelte related screencasts and contents. So please go through all the videos, and I'm sure you will be pretty good with Svelte. I really believe Svelte is one of the best, perhaps the best UI framework / libraries for JavaScript. And Drupal, of course, is the best CMS in my mind. And most applications do need content in addition to applications. So Drupal plus Svelte is perhaps the best combination. So let's get started. So here, I already have my custom module that I created in the last two videos. And I'm going to basically create a directory. Let's create mkdir, Drupal web, and this is my web root, modules custom. And here's my custom module, and there is already a component directory, and I'm going to so components directory, that is right, and then there is one component already. I'm going to create another component, comp svelte one. Okay, so I created that directory, and within that directory now, I am going to create, let's see, components comp, and then there is svelte one, right? So right click. New file, comp underscore svelte one dot component dot yml. So make note of the fact that this directory contains s components. It's the this directory is components plural, while this file yaml file is component as in singular. Okay, so with that in mind, let's populate this yaml file. Let me cheat a little bit. I'm going to look at my cheat sheet. Yeah. So what I do is I have to specify the name, the human readable name of the component. It'll be Svelte component demo, or Svelte demo component, if you will. Description is whatever you like. So Svelte app as Drupal block, if you will. And then you give a JS file to include, and CSS files rather to include. And finally, the form configuration. This is the form that will be attached to the block. When you place the block, this config form will provide the config. So then if you want to provide a config item called name, the machine name is name. It's a user visible name, or title is visitor name, and the type is, the input type is text field. And then default value could be anything. And let's put it as world, because we are going to print hello world. Let's see. So if I save this, now the only thing missing is JS and CSS. Before we do that, before we populate it, let's see if this actually shows up in our user in our Drupal. So structure block layout, if I try to place it, I don't see, oh, I do, wait, let me make sure, let me flush all caches. Okay, yeah, so it's there. This is the one I gave. If I change it, just to see that this is the one that I'm playing with, I'm going to change this from Svelte component demo to Svelte demo component. back to my browser, refresh. Let's see. Place block. Svelte component demo. This is the old description of the component, old name of the component. But if I flush all caches and try to do this again, place block, Svelte demo component still. And yeah, demo component, sorry, that's the new name. My bad. Okay. Now let's take care of JavaScript and CSS. The problem is we do not have a Svelte application just yet. Let's create it. We create it by first we cd into that directory where we need to go, the component directory. So web modules custom my components directory and cd further Svelte one directory. Now I will run npx digit. This is how we start all applications, Svelte applications, npx digit svelte.js template. And since we already have a directory, we will use dot as the target for digit. But that doesn't work because the directory is not empty. We have to use minus minus force option. And now when we go back and refresh this, right now we don't see other files, but if I refresh it, I see them all. Okay. So this, let me just show you what's in there. This is a typical Svelte application. You have public directory containing global CSS, fav icon, and index. We will not be using it. You have scripts, don't worry about it. It's src with main.js and app.svelte, and we will use those. So when we so in order to use it, first we must run. We must run the yarn, or I can run npm install, or I prefer yarn, so I'll just run yarn, which runs the dependency installation, fetches the dependencies. Now, in order to use it, I'm going to use npm scripts, in which is a feature of VS Code, and I'm going to find my Svelte one component demo here. There it is, Svelte one. Yep. So I'm going to now run dev target on npm scripts. And at this point, if I follow this link, I can see the Svelte application. Okay, hello world from Svelte. Okay, so this is a Svelte app. But that's not how I want to use this app. I want to use it as a as an embedded block. So in order to do that, let's take a look at where the JS, let's refresh again, where the so JS and CSS files are here, bundle.js and bundle.css under component directory, public, build, and then, okay. So that's what we are going to do. We are going to place the path to JS and CSS inside the component YAML. So public slash build slash bundle.js colon empty curly braces. Now the meaning of empty curly braces simply is that include this JS file in every page where this block will be included. There are some advanced use cases that I'm not going to discuss at this point. Similarly, CSS, same thing, but JS becomes CSS. Let's save these two. And now, if I go in here and clear cache, flush all caches, and go back to the site. And here, the Svelte component is not even placed, sorry. I guess we need to place it, okay? structure block layout. And let's place the Svelte component. I have the old demo component one, just for the sake of to remove the confusion, let me disable it. And now when I go back to site, I don't see anything. Let's come back to structure block layout and place this block. The block is going to be my Svelte block. There it is, Svelte demo component. Place the block, and it has this configuration parameter world. And so this is my config form, remember, that I configured right here. Visitor name is visitor name here. The default value is being used. I can change it to hello Svelte. So just Svelte. So save block. And if I now move it just above the main page content and save it, back to site shows me hello world. Oh, looks like I put it in a in the wrong place. Let's see if I can reposition it. Structure block layout. I guess I moved it in the wrong place. The Svelte main page component, Svelte demo component. That seems right, but for some reason it showed up in a place where I did not expect it. I expected it above the main page component. Okay, let me refresh. Svelte demo component, yes. Any case, back to site, and it's showing up hello world. It's not even correct. This is not where I expected it, and it's not even the, it shouldn't be world. So let's see, why is it at the very bottom? Let's examine that. Oh, cool. I think I know. That's because the main.js is targeting, as you can see, it is still targeting document body, and that's why it ended up at the very bottom. So let's fix that. What we need to do is, instead of targeting the document body, we need to have another target. Let's create const target is equal to something, and then we will, instead of targeting that, we will target it, the target. And props, again, instead of supplying name world, we will create a new local variable const called props. And now we can just say props equal to props. Now let's find the target first. The target is going to be, we use document.query selector. And let me just make this a little, yeah, query selector. And then let's find the, we need to find, this is the Svelte demo component. It is the one we will inspect. And under that, we want to find the div that can, that has the appropriate parameter. See this? This is the data name Svelte. This is the one we want to target. So if we want to target it, we find the class here, this class. Dot, so that targets the outermost div, then the content div, so dot content, then this div, which contains the data attribute. So, and here's the class for it. Okay, once we target those things, we have the correct, correct DOM element. Now, once we have the target in our hand, we say target.dataset. That's our, target data set. Because as you might have learned in previous videos, these properties, So if I, let me just inspect and I'll show you. This is the inspect. And if I go to $0.dataset, it contains the name property. See, that's what we are trying to extract. But the type is not a plain object. It's a DOM string map. We want a plain object. So the way we get a plain object is we spread the data set. And that will give us the target DOM element and its data set as props. And that's what we are passing to the new app. Okay, so now watch what happens. I'll close this. If I refresh, the hello world, which was broken in the wrong place, it's no longer doing, it's not no longer using document dot, the document element as the target. It's using the correct DOM element. And it not only that, it receives the correct data set. That's why it's no longer saying hello world, it's saying hello sweat. All right, so let me recap. We have to provide this component, YAML file in which we provide the correct JS and CSS, we provide the form configuration, we place the block, and quite importantly, in main.js, instead of targeting the document.body as the target, we target the document query selector and then appropriate selector in there so that this particular div gets targeted. Okay. From that div, we extract the data set as our props and we pass it in. Okay. So, of course, we can now make some changes to this app.svelte. Like, for example, here, if I remove this visit, blah, 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 if I save it and reload that visit. Okay, let me bring it back. I'm not even sure. So, something is not right. It broke. Okay. Looks like connection refused. Okay. Something. Am I getting errors? I don't know. Let me make sure. There's a Svelte demo component. So that's very much there. Let's flush all caches. App.svelte. I don't know. Things have broken down. Very start task, maybe. Okay. That time it worked. Not sure what was wrong. But any case. So this is visit the Svelte tutorial to learn how to build Svelte apps. If I remove this, save it, that will cause a recompile. And if I hard reload this time, the extra statement is gone. The extra paragraph is gone. All right. So we were able to embed Svelte into Drupal as a block, but things don't stop here. This is just the beginning. It's more fun if we can create a web component or a custom element. So that's where Svelte shines, and it's very easy. You just have to know one small trick. So let's try that. What we will do is we will create yet another folder and a file. So new. Let's create a new file called comp_svelte2. That's the name of the directory. And the file will be comp_svelte2.component.yml. This is the thing. Now, this is going to be, you know, very similar, almost the same as the other one. In fact, let's just copy. Let me see if I can, again, I'm just making sure I'm not making any mistakes. So yeah, we can just copy the other one. Let's go to the component YAML file and copy everything. Copy and come back to this component YAML, new one, and paste it. Except that this is going to be spelled demo web component. Oops. Web component. And this will be spelled custom tag as Drupal block. Okay. And everything is same. There is one thing that we will change. We will, because we need, whenever we create a custom element, we need to instantiate that custom element, which we will do in index.html. So let's specify a template file of index.html. What does that do? It basically gives a body to the block. And so the body of the block will become, actually, let me just, new file, index.html. And here, if the name of our tag is going to be svelte underscore comp. This is just obviously a contrived name, but it demonstrates the purpose. Okay, so if this is the body, this index.html will become the body of the block, because we specified the template is index.html. Now we have to get the svelte application here. So let's do that. I am going to go to this comp svelte 2, and in order to make the svelte application show up here, I have to say the same npx digit that I was doing a minute back, right? And that brings me the svelte application. And if I refresh, I see all these things, yes. But I have to make a couple of changes. Actually, a bunch of changes. First, I want to generate a custom element. So we will not be mounting. The mounting part will automatically happen through this. There is no need to mount. Okay. So we go into the main.js and get rid of all of this. We simply say we want to import the app and export it as default. So we can import and say export default app. You can do it this way, or there is a shortcut method, which is export default from app.svelte. This is the short and sweet method of doing that. Okay, so then in app.svelte, first thing we have to do is we have to add a directive. Yes, so svelte colon options, and you give it a tag name. The tag, if you remember, is svelte underscore comp. That's the tag we chose. So you do that. That makes it, that will convert this app.svelte into a custom tag, svelte-comp. There's one more thing you have to do. You also have to go to rollup config.js and then find the svelte compiler, this one, and add a compiler option, which is custom elements true. So then it will compile the svelte files as custom elements. Not all, the entry points, actually. Okay, so once you do all these things, let's see if this works. Let's go back to our app.svelte. Okay. And let's see what if any of this works. We'll find out. First thing, flush all caches, so that Drupal is made aware of the existence of this new component. Let's go to structure block layout and place block under content region. And now we have Svelte demo web component. Excellent. Let's place that. We will leave this as world for now, but we will see what happens. Save it and place it, let's say, above the demo component. Save blocks. Back to site. And you see the Svelte demo web component did not do what we expected it to do. That's fine. Inspect it. And make sure that we have the, let's see the body of this content body. The content body is good. It's svelte-comp. That's good. That's good. That's very good. But let's see. Are we seeing some errors? Let's see the errors. Refuse to apply style, blah, blah, blah. Refuse to apply style. Okay. I don't think that's the issue right now. Here. Oh, of course. We have not started compiling our Svelte web component. So let's do that. So let's see the, we are already there. So let's run yarn install or npm install. That'll do all of them do something similar. I prefer yarn. Okay. Then we go to npm scripts and here do we have the, we should refresh. And in the component demo, I want to find my Svelte 2. Where is it? Is this the? Oh, there are two of them. See, this is the Svelte 2. Okay, run dev, npm run dev kind of thing. Oops, something failed. Error, unrecognized option, custom elements. Did you mean custom element? I guess that's what I did mean. Let's go into rollup config and fix this. Custom element, save it. And, somehow it worked, but no, let's not risk it. Let's run the dev again. Okay, no errors this time. And it should be now compiling stuff. And look, I got Svelte demo web component, hello, but hello undefined. So the issue is that the name prop has not been supplied. And that's the, so if I, let me close all these. Okay. So the issue is that in my web component, which is this guy here, src app.svelte, the name property never gets supplied. Of course it doesn't, because there's nobody to supply that. You are a custom element. But the name property is there, it's just not in the right place. You inspect and go up. You see, this is my Svelte comp. And here's the name property, data-name. That's the one I want, right? So the way we extracted it, so there's a little bit of a trick here. We use the one of these special Svelte tricks. Let me show you one second. So we use the get current component. In Svelte internals, there is a, so import from Svelte internals, something called get current component. We want to basically, here's what we want to do. We want to get access to the, to this, this DOM element. That's what we want to do. And then we will go to parent element and extract the data set from that. That's what we will do. So to do that, you have to use get current component, okay? And then you call the get current. So you say const comp is equal to get current component. This gives you the DOM element that represents this component in DOM. And then from that, you can say parent node dot data set. And this would be your configuration. So you say const config is this, but we don't want to directly up, you want to clone it like this so that it goes from special type of object to a generic object. Okay. And then now we can destructure this config. Let name, instead of export let name, we just say let name is equal to, and then destructure from config. Oops, I meant the other way around. I meant this, destructure from config. All right, once you do that, now let me explain the trick again. Get current component, when you call it, it will get you this DOM element, this one. Okay, svelte dash com. And then you go to parent node, which is this one, and then get the data set, which is an amalgamation of an object representing all the attributes that start in data dash star. And that's what you're going to get here in config now. So once you do those things, refresh, and boom, hello world. You can even configure this block further and then replace the world with svelte world or svelte web component. Save block, hello svelte web component. That's nice. So this is how you can create web components. Let me just give you a quick recap. In order to create web components, you have to add svelte options like this to your app.svelte. You have to use get current component in order to get a handle to the DOM element that is the web component. You do have to go to rollup.config and add a compiler option called custom element equal to true. Okay, and and then finally you have to go create a special template which instantiates your custom element like this, and you have to declare that, you have to use it, you have to specify that in the component YAML file as the template. Okay, so we are going to do more things after this there are a few things that are missing, but this is a good start. We are going to further create full-fledged Svelte applications that could use Drupal GraphQL API or REST API or JSON API. So those are the things we will be doing. I hope you learned something, and see you in the next video.